Hello, this is Richard Walker from Lucidate, and welcome to this seventh video in the series on GPT-3 and transformers. In this video, we're going to continue our discussion on fine-tuning transformer neural networks. Fine-tuning allows you to create your own bespoke models on the most up-to-date content. In the last video, we discussed why you would want to use fine-tuning. In both this episode and the next, we'll discuss how you fine-tune. In this first video, we'll look at the basic methods that you can use for prompt engineering. In the next video, we'll take this to another level and show you how you can build much more complex data pipelines and get your prompts from audio and video sources, such as podcasts, videos, and conference calls. In both these next two explainers, we're going to dive into some code written in Python. But this is not a coding tutorial. There are way better YouTube channels out there for that. We'll just be using some Python to cement the concepts and show how straightforward fine-tuning is. If you know some Python already, then that's great. I hope these concepts are useful. If you don't know any Python, then I'm willing to bet there are a bunch of people in your firm that do. So if you need to manage projects involving fine-tuning AI models, then I hope you get something from this too. So in this video, we'll discuss a couple of easy methods for creating prompts and completions, and we'll also look at some simple text manipulation so that you can build automated pipelines for fine-tuning. It should be pointed out that the most straightforward method of creating prompts and completions is just to manually populate an Excel spreadsheet with two columns. One will be called prompts and the other called completions. Now, I'm not going to recommend that you do this. I'm going to recommend that you look at some of the more automated and scalable ways to write pipelines. This approach will work, and you absolutely can fine-tune a model this way. The end model won't behave any differently if you've trained it manually or if you've used voice recognition from podcasts. More on that in the next video. But manually updating a spreadsheet won't scale. And the reason you're interested in AI in the first place is because of the efficiency multipliers that you get. So I'm recommending that you do not do this, or you only do this as an absolute last resort. By the way, I know you will do it. And if I'm being completely honest, I've done it too. So, with that shameful admission out of the way, let's look at something more systematic. It may have come to your attention that the internet is full of content, a huge amount of text, sound, and video. In this tutorial, we'll look at text and save audio and video for our next episode. I'll share some tools with you that you can use to manipulate text, as well as tools to retrieve relevant passages of text from the internet. In our last video, we discussed a couple of reasons why we would want to fine-tune. Firstly, we'd like our content to be as up-to-date as possible so that it's relevant. Secondly, we'd like to make our NLP model less of a generalist and more specialized in our specific field, such as capital markets. Accordingly, we'll want to train it on recent and relevant articles. By fine-tuning it on relevant prompts and completions during training, we're getting the model to update its query, key, and value matrices in its attention heads. These updated Q, K, and V matrices will mean that during inference, the model will be able to generate output that is both more relevant and up-to-date. So by fine-tuning our transformer with a prompt of an article title and a completion of the article text, we're updating the attention heads in the transformer. Likewise, if we use an individual sentence as a prompt and the next 5 or 10 sentences that follow as our completion, we're providing the grammar with updated Q, K, and V matrices that are more representative of recent developments in our field. When we fine-tune a transformer, we're teaching it new stuff. When we teach it new stuff, it learns. The manifestation of that learning are updated weights in the query, key, and value matrices. If you're unfamiliar with the concept of attention, query, key, and value matrices, please click on the link in the description or the pop-up on your screen. There are two specific problems that we must solve. Firstly, we want to be able to grab relevant text to train our model from the internet. This text will likely be in the form of articles and reports that we will use to build our prompts and our completions. Rather than have these articles pop up nicely formatted in our browser, we'd instead like just the text of these articles to pop up in an app that we write so that we can generate some prompts and completions from this text. Secondly, once we've got this text in our app, we need to do some manipulation on it so that we can break it up into prompts and completions. By manipulations, I mean things like ripping out titles and section headings, which are good candidates for prompts. Likewise, paragraphs of text are great candidates for completions. Similarly, we'd like to be able to break up paragraphs into component sentences so that we can use a particular sentence as a prompt and the text from the next, say, 5 or 10 sentences that follow it as its completion. This means we'd like some code in our app that will grab text and chunk it up into things like headings and sentences. Let's tackle the second of these problems first. Let's start with some simple text. In this example, we have a title and a sample paragraph of text. What we want to do is feed this text into some function that will chunk it up into individual sentences. We can then use some of the chunks as prompts. Let's say every third sentence will be a prompt, and then we'll want to use the remaining chunks of text between the prompts as our completions. So let's grab the first sentence, here highlighted in purple, as our first prompt. GPT-3 can be fine-tuned. And then the next two sentences, in yellow, are the completion text that follows. We'll then repeat this with the fourth sentence and the two sentences that follow that. Then finally, the seventh sentence and the single sentence that follows that. This gives us quite a high-resolution prompt and completion sample on our chosen text. We can add to this with a lower resolution prompt and completion by then taking the title text as our prompt and the entire 8-sentence paragraph that follows as our completion. This will give us a total of 4 prompts and 4 completions from this sample of text. So we'll need to write some code to do this. Please look away if Python code makes you feel squeamish. Firstly, here's a function in Python that will take a string of text as input and break it down into its component sentences and return a list of all of the sentences in the text. The Python magic here is this regular expression. This checks for a full stop, a question mark, or an exclamation mark, followed by one or more spaces. It uses this delimiter to split the string into a list of all the sentences and returns this list as the output of the function. Now, that's a great start, but we need more than just a list of strings. We want to be able to take the nth sentence and use it as our prompt, and then use all the intervening sentences as its completion until we hit the next prompt. We might like to vary how frequently we'll generate prompts. Will it be every 3 sentences in the example we've just seen, or might we want it to generate less frequent prompts for longer completion, say a prompt every 5 or 10 sentences? To do that, we should pass a variable into the function that will determine how frequently we generate our prompts. So here is the function. Now it's doing a little more, so it looks a little bit more intimidating to the non-Pythonista, but let's break it down. Once the text is split into sentences, we've seen how to do that, the function groups them into prompts and completions. A prompt is simply the first sentence of each group, while the completion is the remaining sentences in the group. The function creates 2 lists, one for prompts, and it does this by slicing up the sentences and taking the nth sentence in the list. And then another list for completions, which it does by looping through the intervening sentences and appending them to a completions list. Finally, the function creates a dictionary, which in Python is a set of name-value pairs that maps each prompt to its corresponding completion, and uses something called the pandas library to convert this dictionary into something called a data frame. Think of a data frame as a tabular data structure in Python, similar to an Excel spreadsheet. The resulting data frame contains two columns, one for prompts and one for completions, making it easy to feed the data into a language model for fine-tuning or other applications. If we run this code on a dummy text string containing 50 sentences, we can see that it's taken every fifth sentence as a prompt and the intervening sentences as completions. Now, at this point, we're pretty much done. Frankly, this code will work well for most purposes, but to make it just a little bit more robust, we'll add some simple error checking, as well as some methods to output the results of this function to a JSON file, a CSV file, and an Excel spreadsheet. We can bundle all of this up in a simple class. To initialize an object of this class, you can pass in the string to be split and a number that represents how often we'll create a prompt, say every fifth or tenth sentence. We have our familiar function to split our sentence. In this version, we've made it a little bit more robust with some simple error checking. Finally, we've added three functions to the end that will create firstly an Excel file, secondly a CSV file, and finally a JSON string from our pandas data frame. We can then write a short script to create such an object. As inputs, we pass in a string and the number 5 to indicate we would like every fifth sentence to be a prompt. When we run this code, we can see the generated spreadsheet that contains our prompts and completions created from the text we supplied. So we've solved the problem of splitting up our text. The next thing to solve is to be able to get text from the internet. To do that, we're going to use a popular Python package called Beautiful Soup. When you view a web page in a browser, you make a request to a web server and it sends back some HTML. This contains all of the content and formatting so that your browser can display it. Beautiful Soup allows you to grab the individual components of the HTML, and instead of displaying them in a browser, they're returned to your Python program. So here's an example of how it works. Make sure that a website you visit and use Beautiful Soup on doesn't mind having its content scraped. A website called Quotes to Scrape is a pretty safe bet. Here, my browser has rendered the content. Now, here's a simple Python script using Beautiful Soup that will visit this site and pull back the HTML. It then uses Beautiful Soup to display the data from our program. When we run it, we can see the first Einstein quote. Now, let's modify the script just a little so that we can see more of the content of the page. In both cases, we're able to get the content we need back as a text string. Now recall, we can use this string as an input into our previously described splitter class. So finally, let's look at the Wikipedia page for Beautiful Soup. Scraping this page might be a little bit like a chef using their own recipe book to cook dinner, or a hairdresser cutting their own hair. But hey, sometimes you just have to embrace the meta and let the beauty of Beautiful Soup do its thing. In this video, we've continued our discussion on fine-tuning transformer neural networks. We spoke about why fine-tuning is important and how it can be used to create bespoke models. We discussed basic methods for prompt engineering and simple text manipulations to build automated pipelines for fine-tuning. The most straightforward method is to manually populate an Excel spreadsheet with two columns, one called prompts and the other called completions. But this is not scalable. Please only consider this as a last resort. Do as I say, not as I do. The internet is full of content, and we can use tools to manipulate text and retrieve relevant passages from the internet. We identified two specific problems that need to be solved. One, grabbing relevant text from the internet, and two, chunking it up into prompts and completions. We saw how to solve the second problem by building a splitter class in Python. To solve the first problem, we introduced Beautiful Soup. This popular Python library allows users to extract HTML components of a web page instead of displaying them in a browser. We saw how to use Beautiful Soup to extract text from a website, such as quotes to scrape, or the Wikipedia page for Beautiful Soup. Finally, we emphasized the importance of fine-tuning AI models to achieve efficiency multipliers and scalability. This is Richard Walker from Lucidate. Thanks for watching. Please join me in the next episode where we will look at more sophisticated ways of building prompts and completions using newsfeed APIs, audio and video.